This video introduces Excel Solver, and we are going to use Solver to calculate an economic order quantity. This is chapter 16 in your textbook. EOQ is the number of units which minimizes total inventory cost. Total inventory cost is the sum of order cost plus storage cost. Let's look at a problem from your textbook. In this example, you work for a game developer. You have been tasked to determine the optimum inventory control policy for a computer game. You understand that demand will be 5,000 units annually. It costs $14.40 to place an order, and the storage cost of holding one unit in a warehouse is $10 per year. Now, let's determine the economic order quantity using Excel. First, let's make sure that we have Solver installed in Excel. Click on the Data tab and look over on the far right side of the taskbar and see if the Solver icon is added. If it is, great, you already have Solver. If it isn't, it's an easy add-in. First, click the File tab, then find Options at the bottom, click Add-ins, click Solver Add-in, then click Go and OK. That should install Solver. There are three ways to solve an economic order quantity problem. We can approximate the optimum inventory quantity by looking at the minimum point of the total cost curve. Second, we can solve for the EOQ algebraically, and that method is described in your text. And third, we can calculate EOQ using the Solver capability in Excel. Solver is a highly efficient optimization tool in Excel. It can be used for many problems. EOQ is just one of them. Solver relies on a small input table of values in order to calculate EOQ. Let's transfer the values from the problem into this table. First, order cost, $14.40. Second, our annual demand is 5,000 units. Third, our storage cost is $10 per unit. Our quantity, this is the value that Solver will provide for us based on minimizing the total cost curve. We need to initialize this value with any positive number. Doesn't matter what it is, let's just say 50. Excel will take that value as a starting point and improve that value incrementally by minimizing the total cost curve. So it doesn't matter what value you put in, as long as it's a positive number. Total cost is order cost plus storage cost. It's equal to our order cost, which is found in D7, times the value in D8, divided by the value in D10, plus storage cost, which is the value in D9, times D10, divided by 2. If we were going to place orders of 50 units, that would be 100 units per year. The total cost for this inventory policy would be $1,690. But let's find what the optimum or minimum total cost would be. So let's open up Excel Solver, go to the Data tab, and click on Solver. A window opens, requiring several inputs. First, our objective is to minimize total costs, so our objective function is found in cell D11. So just type in D11. We want to minimize that total cost, so always click minimize. And we want to minimize total cost by changing the value of Q, our quantity, and that is found in cell D10. Those are the three inputs required. You don't need to enter any constraints. Make sure that this unconstrained variables being non-negative is always checked, and make sure that we select GRG nonlinear as our solution method, because our total cost curve is a nonlinear curve. Click Solve. Click OK. And we see our solution, our Q, now increases to 120 units per order. And our total cost, recall before, our non-optimum cost was $1,690 per year. Our optimum minimum total cost is now $1,200 per year. So we can write that our optimum order quantity is 120 units per order, at a total cost of $1,200. Now, whenever you state the optimum order quantity, never write that value as a decimal. Always round up to the next highest whole unit. We can't order or produce a fraction of a unit. If you would round the decimal number down, then you've got a possibility of generating a stock out by not having sufficient inventory to meet the demand. You never want that to happen. So you always round up to the next highest whole number. What's very useful with Solver is that we can solve hypothetical what-if analyses very easily. For example, what if the storage cost would drop by 20%? What would be the impact on EOQ? Well, let's go back, change the storage cost value to 20% less, or $8 per unit, and let's resolve this problem. We'll go to Solver, the pointers to the input values remain the same, we haven't changed those. Click on Solve, and you'll see the new solution. If our storage cost drops by 20%, our economic order quantity would increase to 135 units per order, and our total cost would fall to $1,073.31. I hope you enjoy using Solver. Play around with it and get comfortable. Thank you.